just want to reiterate our thankfulness to all of the volunteers that were out here this week. We had over 50 volunteers helping y'all out. You know, we get to run around and get warm out there when it's really cold, but they are standing still in all of their gear with 50 mile an hour winds and rain coming down. So I'm so thankful for them. Also want to thank our host golf course, Bandon Dunes Golf Resort. They are amazing. As well as the owner, Mike Kaiser, who provides the purse for the professionals. So really, really amazing. Again, we have a few other sponsors this year. Like before, we have Sun Mountain, who has manufactured our Speedgolf bag. They also provided us with our outerwear. And they are an amazing sponsor, so we're very thankful for them. As well as we had Strixon come on board this year as the official ball sponsor, so we look forward to a continuing relationship with them. We also have legal people right here who has been extremely supportive of this event, so it's... We had Golf Dots come on this year, and if you guys haven't seen them, the Golf Dots are basically little tattoos for golf balls. And so they made up golf dots for each of the logos for all of the golf courses here. You all got them in your bags. So please, like I said before, support them. If you like them, go on their website and continue to buy those and tell other people about that. Let's see, any other sponsors?
RA
Sports Management. We can't forget about them. See, Graham's not even here right now because he's out there still working. So let's put our hands together for Graham. Okay, incredible tournament. So I'm going to turn it over to Tim.
Yeah. How about the pro part first?
Pro part. Let's do the pro part first. Let's definitely do that. So, professionals today, the scores at the top were really tight. So we'll go through, actually, just a couple of highlights there. We had, for the first time ever, in speed golf, it's very rare to have a tie, because you have to not only have the same score, but you have to have the same amount of seconds. And so for the first time ever, that happened today, and there was a tie for seventh place between Joe Matsui and Jamie Young. They both shot 126-49. So that's sixth place was Matt DeLynn with 124.52. Just in fifth place was Mark Stockhamp. Mark, are you still here? I think he had to leave. If y'all don't know, Mark Stockhamp had a difficult time, like all of us. But Mark approached me after that round and just said, you know, I'm embarrassed. And he said, I'm not embarrassed for me. I'm embarrassed for speed golf. And I really don't know if I want my score to be shown. I said, listen, You tried as hard as you could today. Tomorrow's going to be a different day. And he came out today and shot an 81. I'm sorry. He shot a 76 in 48 minutes, and he finished in fifth place with the professional. He really does represent the spirit of speed golf. He's courageous. He never gave up, and he got rewarded for that. So that's really wonderful. Mac McClain finished in fourth. He shot an 81 in 42 minutes. Alan Phillips, who also could not be here this afternoon, he's on his way back. He shot 76 in 47 minutes for 123. All right, and then our runner-up this year, just by about 56 seconds, shooting an 83 in 39 minutes and 57 seconds. Guess who that was? Rob Hogan. He had a score of 122.57. And this year's Speed Golf World Champion 2014, shooting a score of 76 in 46 minutes and 1 second for a total of 122.01, is Ari Crum.
First of all, I had the luxury today to have sunshine, and I
think I was eating my eggs and coffee when the rain came out. I mean, full force. And there you guys are starting, and it was incredible. I was very thankful to I think get some better weather than you guys had today. Thank you so much again to Scott, Jim, Tim, Chris for creating this wonderful sport for us. It's such an honor to be here, and I really appreciate what you've done to create an awesome sport that I hope continues to grow. Thank you guys for having the courage to come out here combine two very different sports into something completely different, and I hope it continues to grow. I know it will continue to grow. It's such an awesome sport. Thanks to Bandon Dunes, this is not the mecca of golf. I mean, it's the greatest place on earth to play. Every time I come out here, I'm so thankful to be able to play the four awesome courses. You got to, if you haven't, make sure you play all four courses plus the par three course. They're awesome. So, thank you very much. Great.
Tim here, and we're going to go through the results for the amateurs. Before I do that, I want to mention one thing, which is that this weekend there's been an amazing amount of information and data and pictures and everything going out on social media, and it's been incredible. We've gained a lot of new followers, and I want to encourage each and every one of you that do those kinds of things to continue to post and to continue to spread the news about speed golf. Don't let the passion, the excitement die down when you leave here. But let's all work together. You know, the four of us can only do so much, and we're doing everything that we can. But with y'all's help, we can get there a lot quicker. So go home, and whenever you play speed golf, take a picture, post it. We'll repost it, and let other people around the world know what's going on in your part of the world with speed golf. And that would really be helpful. So we appreciate you guys doing that.